For over 75 years, the mystery of what happened to the incredible treasure-filled cache known as the Amber Room has gone unanswered. As during 1944, the pieces of the room seemed to disappear from the map. In its place, a brand new Amber Room was constructed to ease the pain from the loss. Today, we're going to explore what happened to the original Room of Wonder. We'll explore how it was created, as well as the various theories on what fate befell the amber-laden hoard, such as the new evidence that recently came to light that may hold answers at the bottom of the Baltic Sea. So, let's get started. The creation of this breathtaking room first began in 1701. It was set to be installed within the confines of the Charlottenburg Palace, which is based in Berlin, Germany. At the time, it was the home of King Frederick I of Prussia, who had become the first king of Prussia that same year. The room itself was designed by Andreas Schluter, a German sculptor and architect. The actual construction of the Amber Room was aided by the master craftsman Gottfried Wolfram, who served King Frederick VI of Denmark. Amber masters Ernst Schacht and Gottfried Thurau of Poland were also involved in the construction. However, as the panels were being created, the location of the Amber Room was changed, as decided by the new King of Prussia, Frederick William I. Now, the room would reside in the Berlin City Palace. As such, further work was required. Beyond being a key element in pop culture, such as in the 1993 film Jurassic Park, and known as Old Amber in the Pokemon franchise, real-life amber was an important aspect in the past, as it was often used in Europe and Asia centuries ago as a medicine for a variety of issues. In ancient China, amber was thought to bring luck and help mend the mind. Amber has even been used to help babies with their teething. However, there is little evidence that it actually has healing properties. Amber is actually fossilized resin from trees. It has been used in jewelry for around 13,000 years. While the usually orange substance is pretty, its monetary value can fluctuate drastically. In 2018, an amber necklace went up for auction at Sotheby's. It has an estimated value of between 3,000 to 5,000 pounds, which is roughly between $3,900 and $6,500. However, the necklace went unsold. By 1717, the Tsar of Russia, Peter the Great, was gifted the breathtaking room by King Frederick William I. The Amber Room was used as a sweetener to create an alliance between Prussia and Russia against Sweden. With aid from Russian and German craftsmen, the Amber Room was relocated to Russia. Eventually, on the request of the future Empress of Russia, Elizabeth Petrovna, the room was installed in Catherine Palace in Saint Petersburg. This palace was used by the royal family during the summer months. The new location of the room was redesigned by Bartolomeo Francesco Rastrelli of Italy. It took a further 10 years to construct the Amber Room in Russia, but when it was done, it was beautiful. So much that it was described as the eighth wonder of the world. Over its lifetime, the Amber Room was used for private meditation, a gathering room, and trophy space. The room contained amazing carvings of angels and children to further enhance the beauty of the room. Altogether, the design covered 55 square meters, or 590 square feet. The amount of amber used in the room is said to have weighed 6 tons. That's roughly the weight of 8 average cows. On top of the intricate amber designs, the room also contained gold leaf and gemstones to further add to the luxury. There were also mirrors to help illuminate the room further via candlelight. As far as how much it would have been worth, the estimates vary. In 2007, it was valued at $142 million, yet in 2016, it was estimated to be worth over $500 million. By June 1941, World War II was underway. As part of expanding the Third Reich, the German leaders issued Operation Barbarossa. Previously, the then Soviet Union and Germany signed a pact, but Germany soon decided to break that deal and invade their former ally. On that fateful day, Germany sent in one of the largest invasion forces in history. 3 million Axis soldiers flooded into Western Soviet Union. The operation lasted until December 1941. Millions, both soldiers and civilians on both sides, were wiped out. As part of Operation Barbarossa, Germany proceeded to loot thousands of pieces of Soviet art, especially in St. Petersburg, or what was named at the time Leningrad. As the forces approached Catherine Palace, the Soviet officials had a choice to make. What do they do with the Amber Room? The first thought was to move it themselves and hide it. However, the amber was old and began crumbling as soon as they attempted to take it down. So the officials covered the room with dull wallpaper, hoping that the Germans wouldn't realize the treasure underneath. Unfortunately, it didn't work. Within 36 hours of arriving on the scene, the Germans had deconstructed the Amber Room. In various crates, the pieces were sent to a castle in what was formerly known as Königsberg in Prussia. Today, it's known as Kaliningrad, Russia. In November 1941, a Königsberg newspaper announced the exhibition of the Amber Room at the castle. In 1943, German officials ordered that the Amber Room would be packaged up and ready for transportation to somewhere safer. By August 1944, the tide of the war had vastly turned. The Allied forces lay siege to Königsberg, which resulted in much of the town being destroyed, seemingly obliterating the stored pieces of the Amber Room within Königsberg Castle. This is the most believed tale of what happened to the Amber Room. In 2004, investigative journalists Catherine Scott Clark and Adrian Levy came to the conclusion that the room was wrecked during the 9th to the 11th of April 1944, as the Battle of Königsberg came to a close. Even the head of the Soviet Union's team for finding the room, Alexander Brusov, believed this to be the case, although he did change his opinion later down the line. As a result, there are a number of other theories that we'll examine shortly. With the loss of a national treasure, the Soviet Union decided to construct a replica Amber Room in 1979. As a tribute to its history, the room would be situated within Catherine Palace once again. The palace is located in the Tsarskoye Selo in Saint Petersburg, a former residence for the Imperial Russian family. Over 40 Russian and German craftsmen were involved in the reconstruction. They studied old black and white photographs of the original room, even having many of the images painstakingly colored to see it in its former glory. Due to the modern time period, there was a lack of experts in crafting with amber. As such, the room took 24 years to be completed. Altogether, it's believed the new Amber Room cost $11 million to put together, with $3.5 million being donated by the German energy company E.ON. By 2003, the brand new Amber Room was open to the public. The room was even dedicated by Russian President Vladimir Putin and then German Chancellor Gerhard Schroeder at the 300th anniversary of the city of St. Petersburg. Throughout the years, since the original Amber Room was obliterated, a number of pieces have seemingly turned up via the black market and other channels. During 1997, German art detectives located a section of the Amber Room. They found an Italian stone mosaic, one of four pieces that had decorated the fabled room. The stone was being sold by a family via their lawyer. However, the family claimed they had no idea about the item's true worth and history. Although, as it turns out, they were the family of a soldier who stated that he had been involved in boxing up the Amber Room back in the 40s. However, the soldier had long since passed and was unable to tell his tale. The Italian mosaic was then transported to Russia to be used in the reconstruction efforts. As for all the other pieces, there's been various theories on what actually happened to the original Amber Room. Over the years, a number of treasure hunters have made claims to have found the room across the globe. After all, during the war, Germans moved a lot of art and precious items to more secure areas, often without any documentation stating where the prized possessions were. In 1998, a German treasure hunting team believed they located the remains of the room in a silver mine, although in the same year, a team from Lithuania stated they believe it was in a lagoon. Neither team was right. Since Germany was transporting a lot of their looted artifacts to more secure areas, one of the theories of the Amber Room is that the pieces were lost at sea. A number of eyewitnesses claim to have seen soldiers loading the Amber Room pieces onto the military transport ship, the MV Wilhelm Gustloff, on the 30th of January 1945 in Gdynia, Poland. However, soon after being undocked, the boat was sunk by a torpedo from a Soviet submarine, apparently sinking the Amber Room to the bottom of the Baltic Sea. Recently, in October 2020, a new discovery was found within the Baltic Sea near Ustka, Poland. But it's nothing to do with the Wilhelm Gustloff ship. The remains of the ship, named Karlsruhe, was found 290 feet down in the water. The ship is said to have been one of the last boats to leave Königsberg during the mass evacuation by the Axis powers in April 1945. It's believed that Karlsruhe was sunk by Soviet airships a day after setting sail. By retrieving the ship's cargo, which contains military vehicles, art, and many closed boxes, we could soon have an answer to what happened to the original Amber Room. However, the remaining citizens of Königsberg have long since suspected the Soviets were responsible for the Amber Room being destroyed during the battle. It's believed that when the Soviet army took back control of the town, they found remains of the room in good condition. But in order to blame the Germans and shift the blame, they hid the pieces. In fact, this is the speculation on the reason Alexander Brusov changed his views from the Soviet Union accidentally destroying the room to his statement claiming they weren't responsible. Government pressure. As the theory began to take off and get more popular, Soviet officials immediately closed off access to Königsberg Castle to both the public and researchers. Previously, it was open to all. In 1968, the Soviet premier at the time, Leonid Brezhnev, demanded the destruction of Königsberg Castle. The protesters' pleas fell on deaf ears. As the castle was demolished, any hope of trailing the Amber Room from its last known location appeared to be gone. But with the recent discovery of the sunken ship, perhaps we can finally get an answer to this over 75-year-old mystery. What do you think happened to the original Amber Room? Let us know your theories in the comments below. If you enjoyed the video and want to see more, please like, share, and subscribe. All of those actions really help us out. Finally, thanks for joining us today. We'll see you next time.